Have you ever wondered what it would be like to experience the roller coaster, the hard work and the lifestyle of a model? Ever dreamt of strutting down the runway, shooting magazine covers or working with international artists? Who is Angelia Camburis?
Angelia Camburis is a very humble, down-to-earth person.
I wish that I could fly into the sky so very high, just like a dragonfly.
There have been times at a stretch where I've led a very big life, which a lot of people are completely unaware of. And then there are moments that are very, very quiet. Out for lunch in Sydney, and I was whisked away by Alex Perry, and I was completely shocked. So that was basically how I was discovered. I walked into the agency one day with no photos, the day that I was discovered, and a Polaroid was taken of me. Day two, I got called for what they called a cattle call casting, where there's between 3,000 and 5,000 girls. Of course, my number came up. I was nervous as hell. I was looking at all the experienced girls and all the gorgeous girls. Next day, I got a call from the agency saying, guess what, you got the job. And I was like, what? Are you kidding me? So that was quite amazing on day two, and a job that ran for like 13, nearly 15 years. I want to get away. I was the house model for Trent Nathan for at least 8 years running. Charlie Brown and Howard Showers. I was the face of Howard Showers for a couple of years. The look that I had at that stage in Sydney was always on the strong side. Photographers loved it. There wasn't a huge call for that then. So before I knew it, I was packing my bags and going to Europe and working out of Athens. I spent most of my time modeling there, and I landed quite a few contracts in Athens, and I was working in Germany quite a bit, in Italy, doing shows in Paris. I went on a bit of a roll to do Clio, Vogue. I did quite a few for Studio Collections. The owner, Marcello Grand, Italian, suave, debonair man, absolutely loved my look, so I did lots for Studio. In fact, I also appeared in Studio for Men, and I was the first female to ever advertise in men's editorial in a man's suit in Australia.
Who did you look up to?
Sophia Loren for me was the woman I wanted to grow into, basically. The strength, the passion, the style. A lot of my photos people look at and they say to me, wow, it resembles Sophia Loren, and I'm just completely over the moon because, you know, she's my rock that I've idolized forever. More modern would be Linda Evangelista.
What are some of the challenges that you faced throughout your career?
Because I was on a big high with getting a couple of big jobs at first, then of course, you know, there has to be the downslide as well. And when it came, I must admit, I was a bit disheartened. Any girl that's, you know, growing and blossoming and not quite experienced can take that the wrong way, and you start thinking, what's wrong with me? Have I gone ugly all of a sudden? Have I put on too much weight? Why aren't they liking me, you know? And it was just basically, you're not the look that they want for that job. But to survive in this business, you have to take the knocks with the good times. And if you can't take those knocks, you just cannot be a model. Simple as that.
Did any of your Greek-Australian values that you were brought up with at home ever clash with your work?
No. I consciously chose not to do lingerie. I have absolutely nothing against it, but I didn't want to do lingerie. I didn't mind swimwear, nothing suggestive. I couldn't bear the thought of my father coming face to face with anything like that. When my father saw me gracing covers or on a TV commercial or in a film clip, he was as proud as. I have two children, two two beautiful children. I'm teaching, doing special education.
The question on everybody's lips is, how do you look so good at your age? What is the secret?
Well, the secret, there's no number to give you. I would have to say, καλή καρδιά, μεγάλο χαμόγελο και να μην καπνίσετε. Translated, I would say, big heart, big smile, and no smoking.